Welcome back to the adventure. This is Adam, and today we're discussing the differences between every edition of Windows XP. We will get started right after this. Windows XP was released October 25th, 2001, initially with two editions, Home and Professional. Home Edition was designed for the home user and allowed upgrading from Windows 98 and ME. Professional Edition, on the other hand, was designed for businesses. It allowed upgrading from Windows NT and 2000, in addition to including features not found in Home, like joining a domain, remote desktop, encryption, and more. A few months later, in January 2002, Microsoft released Windows XP Embedded. This edition is specifically designed for OEMs to use on equipment like set-top boxes, medical devices, point-of-sale terminals, etc. I want to take a moment to voice a personal opinion on this. There are a lot of jokes about Microsoft and their software, but in all seriousness, it terrifies me that some medical devices run on Windows. If this can happen...
Let's plug it in. It's going to say, hey, I see you've plugged in a new device. And it's going to load in the appropriate drivers. You'll notice that this scanner build, moving right along.
That must be why we're not shipping Windows 98 yet.
Absolutely, absolutely.
What is to say that medical devices could not fail in a similar way? Windows XP Embedded is identical to XP Pro, but can have components completely removed. The benefit to using this edition over Windows CE is the full Windows API and support for a wide range of applications and device drivers. If you ever wondered what happened to Windows 9, it was released exclusively for embedded systems. Now to figure out what happened to the iPhone 9. Next, we have my favorite edition of Windows XP, Media Center Edition. Originally released in September 2002 only to manufacturers, this edition is designed for PCs with TV tuners and included some goodies found in the Windows XP Plus packages, like the screen dancers. In September of 2003, Media Center Edition received a second release referred to as Media Center Edition 2004. That came with Service Pack 2 pre-installed, and again was only available to computer manufacturers. A third and final release was made available to the public as Media Center Edition 2005. It included support for media extenders and CD/DVD video burning. Another point of interest is that Media Center Edition has higher system requirements than XP Pro and Home, specifically a 1.6 GHz processor or faster, DirectX 9.0 hardware accelerated GPU, and 256 MB of RAM. Just 2 months after the original Media Center Edition release came Tablet PC Edition, this time based on XP Pro. It was designed for, you guessed it, tablet PCs, and included support for pen-sensitive and portrait-oriented screens. A few extra goodies were added like Windows Journal, sticky notes, and a game called Inkball. September 29th, 2004 saw the release of Windows XP Starter Edition. This edition was intended to be a low-cost introduction to Windows XP for first-time PC users in developing countries. It is similar to XP Home, but has a focus on low-end hardware, can only run three programs at a time, and has some features either removed or disabled by default. Between 2004 and 2005, Microsoft ran into some legal issues in the European Union. After losing a lawsuit, they released Windows XP Edition N. In a nutshell, including Windows Media Player in Windows XP broke some laws. So Edition N was born. The N means not with Media Player. A similar situation occurred in Korea, resulting in both the Edition K and KN, which excluded Windows Media Player and Windows Messenger. In April of 2005, Microsoft released Windows XP 64-bit edition. The benefits here are the support for 64-bit hardware and an updated kernel. This edition supports up to 128 gigs of RAM, hard drive partitions larger than 2 terabytes, up to 2 physical CPUs on separate physical sockets, and up to 64 logical processors on a single CPU. On November 8, 2008, Microsoft released Windows XP Home Ultra Low Cost Personal Computer Edition. This edition was designed for netbooks. While not exactly an edition like the others we have discussed, it is worth mentioning here. At the time, OEMs needed an operating system to ship with their netbooks, and Microsoft certainly wasn't going to let Linux dominate the netbook market, so they organized a discount program for XP Home. The only difference here is price. If you enjoyed the video, click the card above to find out why Windows Vista is bad. Subscribe for more videos on retro tech and legacy software every Thursday. Thanks for stopping by. See you next video.